longest thing. Is it my keyboard? It's not my keyboard, is it? No, it's not my keyboard. Yep, it was the controller. Go explore the... Oh no, I know where this is taking me. This is what I think it is. I think it's my least favorite area of the game. Or at least it's part of this area. Messing around. That just shows you how, I don't know, look how fast videos go. In fact, if I really wanted to, I could edit videos together and make them 15 minutes, but, you know, it's challenging. You know what, I may do that. After this episode, I'm gonna start doing that, actually. Because I'm not putting any work into my videos at all. I need to start doing work. Like, all I'm doing is pushing out videos. And start, you know, doing things. I believe this is where I got stuck the first time I played through for a while. It's actually where I'm stuck in my hard run right now, because it gets difficult here. Okay. Wait a minute. There's a secret here. It's a missile tank. I remember that because that's one of the places I got stuck. There's 10 Metroids. Another reason I want to get my YouTube channel verified is because I can only upload 15-minute videos. If I wanted to, I could, like, whenever my channel gets verified, I could literally just, like, edit all these videos together and make it, like, a, I don't know, one big video. I could make longer videos, what I really want to do. I believe there's a boss fight coming up, because it's a really important item. It's not necessary. I don't want to say it's necessary, but I don't think many of the items in this are necessary, now that I think of it. I mean, think about it. I don't need Verisuit. I don't need Charge Beam. I don't need Wave Beam. I don't need High Jump. Yeah, I don't need that many of the items. Go down here, I believe, as a missile tank. Go up. Those things are... I'm not wasting time to kill them. I wish they'd make another Metroid game, like, in this art style, you know? Not 2.5D like Samus Returns, but more 2D, you know? Here is something I had trouble with. This is the space jump. It lets us jump infinitely. You see the door's locked. And if you look at this, see it's a boss fight. This is the golden... Chorizo, I think is the name of it. No, it's just chorizo. See, you can go behind it, and that helps you. It's actually how you're supposed to kill it. I didn't know this my first time around, so I had a little bit of trouble on it. Not too much. I've been having webcam problems recently. Like, I believe it still works, just I keep forgetting about it. So, I believe I've killed it. No, I haven't. Now for phase two of the boss. This is where the space jump comes useful. Now we can't even walk down here because it's covered in spikes. See? Whew. I haven't ever died to this in normal mode, I don't believe. I did in hard a lot. Especially in this part. I gotta be dead right now. Mostly because I didn't have enough energy tanks. If they don't do what they did doing a zero mission where they divide it. When is the right word? Where they basically make it half of what it's supposed to be. Zero mission. Most of the energy tanks that would be 99, they're 49. Gah. Oh, I'm supposed to shoot those. That explains a lot. See, if I had a certain power-up, not gonna say which, this would make the fight a lot easier. Okay, then. That works, too. So we just defeated the Chorizo statue, and we got one of the best power-ups in the game, the space jump, which as you saw there, basically, we can jump infinitely. You jump into the spikes either, that's not very good for you. Alright, now you go up here. This work. How did I get up here without the space jump? I don't know. Because I remember I didn't have the space jump in this part. Maybe a bomb jump. No, me, I probably did. Oh, there's a power up over there. In this room, if you shoot through the sand, there's an energy tank. Missile tank. And I believe I'm going to end this episode early, since, you know, new area and stuff. Alright, see you guys next episode.